What do we use T for in Vim? Well, we use it to take us till a certain character. It is a motion key. Till. Hey, welcome back to another episode of a short series on the Vim alphabet. From A to Z, we cover every letter in Vim and what it does. Today, we're talking about T. Let's open up our editor for lipsum.txt. You'll see that this is very similar to F, and I'll post a link to F in the card above. F allowed us to find a certain character. So if I type F and I, it's going to move the cursor to that character, and it's going to sit right on that character. Now, if I want to go before that character, I can use T. So we'll go till I, and that'll put us our cursor right before that character. Now we can also use a number before this. So we can see that we have two T's here. If I wanted to go to till T, that'll put me on this E character right here. It's kind of a convoluted way to navigate. I don't use it that often unless I know exactly that I'm jumping to a specific character. In code, I use this a lot for special characters like angle brackets and things of that nature, commas, etc. Now, uppercase T is just kind of going backwards. It's the opposite direction. So if I wanted to move backwards towards this T into this space right here, I can do a capital T, T, and it moves backwards till the T. Now, if you have any questions about how T works, just do colon H T and get all of the documentation on that. That's all I have for T. It's not a very complicated command. Just remember that it is related to F. So everything that you know about F is going to apply to T as well. It's just going to be on the side of the character, not putting your cursor right on the character. So that's it. I hope you learned something today. If not, better luck tomorrow as we cover U, which we've actually been using through this entire course. See you tomorrow.